Welcome everyone. From today we are starting the series of lectures for engineering physics, and today our topic is electron ballistics. Now starting with this chapter, we must first know what is meant by ballistic. So the meaning of ballistic means the projectiles. So here we have to deal about the electron ballistic, that is the projectiles of electron, that is the motion of the electron. Now starting with the basic topics, in this chapter we will deal with many cases. First in this session we will deal only with electric field, and that electric field will be applied parallel to the electron motion and perpendicular to the electron motion. Now first topic is about, now as we are starting about this electric field topic, so we must know what is meant by electric field. So first we will discuss what is meant by electric field. Let here be an charge Q. The region surrounded by the charge in which the effect of charge is experienced by another charge. आसान भाषा में कहूँ तो अगर if we have put a charge Q on a place and we take an another charge, let it be positive or negative, जब उस charge को हम यहाँ रखते हैं उस पर कोई effect नहीं होता इस charge का, but when we take it in a specific distance from the this charge, a force is applied on the upcoming charge. Hence, the region in which the force is experienced by the upcoming charge due to this initial charge is called as electric field. And electric field is usually mentioned by these electric field lines. Now our next topic is to discuss the motion of electron in uniform electric field. Motion of electron in uniform electric field. To understand this, we must know what is meant by uniform. Uniform is any property of anything or substance which does not changes with the space coordinates. In short, we can say that koi bhi vastu ki wo property which does not change with the position and location of that object in universe, it is called as uniform. And talking here about uniform electric field, isme teen baatein hame yaad rakhni hai. Uniform electric field, the field lines must be parallel to each other, they must be straight line, and they must be equally spaced. The distance between these two electric field lines and these two electric field lines must be same for uniform electric field. Now we have completed that what is meant by uniform electric field. Now we will discuss about the motion of electron in uniform electric field. यहाँ पर तीन केसेस पॉसिबल है. वन केस इज दैट इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज अप्लाइड पैरेलल टू द इलेक्ट्रॉन मोशन, इट इज अप्लाइड परपेंडिकुलर टू इलेक्ट्रॉन मोशन, और इट इज अप्लाइड एट एन एंगल ऑफ थीटा टू द इलेक्ट्रॉन मोशन. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस ओनली टू टॉपिक्स, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, यूनिफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज अप्लाइड पैरेलल टू इलेक्ट्रॉन मोशन, एंड यूनिफॉर्म इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज अप्लाइड परपेंडिकुलर टू द इलेक्ट्रॉन मोशन. फर्स्ट केस, केस वन, electric field applied parallel to electron motion. Here I am not writing uniform, we know that it is uniform electric field, uniform electric field applied parallel to electron motion. Now how to create uniform electric field? As per our knowledge till 12th standard, we know that a capacitor produces uniform electric field. We know that electric field direction are from positive charges to the negative charges. Now in this case we consider that actually this charges, it is connected to battery, and hence charges are induced on this poles, that is positive plus Q and minus Q. Now Here we consider that let here be an electron of mass m. Let an electron of mass m, this electric field intensity be E, and here we consider electron as a point mass. Now here we consider it as point mass. So what does we mean by point mass? So talking about point mass, here point particles in this case means that it is a non-zero charged particle which and no other structure or properties. So point mass से हम ये बता रहे हैं कि it is an मतलब ये वह वस्तु है, it consists some amount of charge but it does not have any other structure or properties. Hence as we are considering it as point mass, we can apply the Newton laws of motion. So we will apply the second law of motion, that is second law of motion, that is F is equal to mass into acceleration. So acceleration is equal to force upon mass. Now force here applied on electron is due to this electric field, and we know that electric field is equal to force applied per unit charge. So force is equal to electric field into charge. So electric field intensity E into charge E, here negative sign due to minus E charge as we are considering electrons, upon m. This is the force, this is the acceleration. Now here we know that E is a constant quantity, electric field will, intensity will also be constant, as here we are considering uniform electric field and mass of electron is also constant. Hence this whole quantity is uniform. Hence the acceleration of the electron in uniform electric field applied parallel to the electron motion will be constant. Now next, as it is constant and we know that uniform the system is having uniform acceleration, is having uniform acceleration, according to our kinematics knowledge we know that when a system have uniform acceleration, we can apply Newton we can apply the kinematic equation. So to describe the motion of electron, we can apply all the three kinematical equations. Kinematic equations. What are kinematic equations? V is equal to U plus A into T. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And V square minus U square is equal to 2A into S. In this case, as we know that we have taken an electron with initial velocity 0, so here we will put u is equal to 0 in all cases, and thus we can describe the motion of electron by using these three kinematic equations. Next, we have to see the energy acquired by the electron in this uniform electric field applied parallel to the motion of, parallel to the, discuss about the energy acquired by the electron. So energy acquired, we will first consider force. Force is equal to minus E into E. Now work is equal to, let it be dW. So is equal to F into dx. Now force applied is equal to minus E into E upon dx. Now as we know that electric field is equal to negative potential gradient. So it can be written as minus E into dV by dx. Here we will have a negative sign, that is its negative potential gradient. So dx, from here we get E dV is equal to dW. To get the whole work, we will integrate both sides. So work done is equal to E into V2 minus V1. Let this be an equation 1. Electron as point mass, so we can apply also the electron, the second law of motion, that is force is equal to mass into acceleration. So this can be written as mass into dV by dt. Now work is equal to mass into dV by dt into dx. Now applying chain rule, we can write it as m into dV by dx into dx by dt into dx. So this dx, dx cancel, and we know that change in position with respect to time is equal to velocity. Is equal to velocity. So this can be written as M into V into dV is equal to dW. Now integrating both sides, we get work done is equal to M by 2 into V2 square minus V1 square. That is change in kinetic energy of the electron. Now considering equation 1 and equation 2, we get E, let us consider that V2 minus V1 is equal to V. Now V2 minus V1 is equal to V, we have considered. So E into V, this V is potential difference between the capacitor's plate which we have taken. So this is equal to half M V square. This V is velocity of electron, this V is potential. So from this we get velocity of electron is equal to root of 2 into V by M. This V is potential difference between the capacitor plates, and this V is velocity of electrons. Please share our YouTube channel RHK Academy, and must give us feedback about if there are any mistakes or any doubts in your mind. Please give us feedback so that we can solve them. Thank you.
Must share and subscribe my YouTube channel.